Then why aren't you in uniform? It's about time you got here!
I know you want to see the rest of Zero Suit be Zero Suit Dragon. I'll probably, like, Zero Suit's name is a joke. I'll probably upload that. I'm trying to figure out a light that I don't want to use for tonight. I have a new live stream. I'm gonna be streaming for kink.com, 18 plus only there. YouTube, don't demonetize this video. I don't think I'm breaking the terms of service.
Porn, right?
Porn?
What's... Oh, pornography? No.
It's okay if you look at porn. I assumed you did anyways. I mean, every guy does. I'm perfectly okay with that, as long as it's not that weird stuff. Oh. All right, well, I mean, kinky's okay. I like kinky. As long as it's not that sick, twisted S&M stuff. Wow. Okay, I'm not gonna judge your journey. It is your fantasy. Just as long as you're looking at women who... Not women? Wow! Okay! Men? Chicks with dicks? Horses? Worse than horses?
I didn't think I am. Anyways, yeah, this is just my cosplay, and I guess I'll show you guys the rest of this video tonight. But I gotta go do a live stream now, so... Gonna do that for a bit, and then we can get ready with the rest of today's vlog. Cause I'm so excited for tomorrow. But yeah, it's my first stream with kink.com tonight, so figured I'd bust out this anyway, cause I wanna film in it for the rest of this today. So, and maybe tomorrow, but we'll see. Okay, I'll see you soon, bye. Everyone, hey guys, I got done with my first, still in the Zero Suit. I don't think it's coming off for the rest of this vlog or video, but yeah, just got done with my first stream with kink.com, and it was pretty sweet, enjoyable at least. Anyhow, so now for the second part, I'm gonna go do my first airsoft match tomorrow, I'm pretty sure, or I'm gonna be to a field called Flash Camp, I think, is what I'm going to. And I have to make sure all my gear is ready for tomorrow, so that's why I cut my stream early. I normally start at 6 and would like to go 6 hours till at least midnight, but I cut it at 10, so I'd have time to do this. Are you ready? She's gonna have to share that chair with me whether she likes it or not. She's gonna have to. I guess this is gonna be my airsoft update. I'm gonna show you guys all the stuff I'm gonna be bringing with me tomorrow, and hopefully by the end of this vlog, it'll all be packed and ready to go in the morning. I'm gonna be leaving at 8.
Voy a la playa, voy a subir la marea.
Look, that's the face of someone who knows that they did trouble. Look at the camera. She knows she's in trouble. Don't give me that shit. go you. Anyhow, so yeah, might as well get my stuff ready for tomorrow. So, let's just go over the loadout really quick. So, loadout time. Part one, tech gloves, combat gloves. You gotta protect yourself from the BBs, yeah, cause like getting shot in the hands is not fun, but really you should just be protecting yourself from the environment, cause you know these playing fields aren't like, I mean you can run around in sports clothes and shit, but you know your likelihood of getting like, you know, cut, a bruise, a splinter or something goes way up. So combat gloves. Step two is plate carrier. You don't really need a plate carrier to play this game, but a lot of people prefer to run plate carriers. This isn't technically a plate carrier, this is more like a tactical vest or a paintball vest. Because a plate carrier actually has a spot in the front to carry bulletproof plates, that's why it's called a plate carrier. This isn't that because it doesn't have a spot for one, although you could totally attach it. This is more just like a tactical vest that allows you to put stuff in it, so let me throw it on and show you. I kind of want to show up in the field tomorrow with all this in nothing but the Zero suit. The Zero suit and like Carrier Dragon Girl. Yeah. Maybe in California we'll do that, but in Indiana I think we're gonna go with the, human girl, air softer, I'm gonna keep calling it a plate carrier, although I know it's not a plate carrier, it doesn't have plates in it, it's just a vest, so I'm gonna keep calling it anyway. Since I will be running a Chris Vector, well, actually let's start at the top here, top right side, I am keeping a... really not a good one, but it's cheap and is the only one that I had in time because I'm sure you all see me by now, I'm a Balisong butterfly knife addict. This is a trainer blade. I don't know if the field I'm going to allows for trainer melee kills. A lot of the airsoft fields I've seen allow for you to carry dummy blades to use as like, you know, you're not gonna go stab someone, you're just gonna go tap them. This counts as a knife. It's more just for style, and it was only like, I think like $8. So right here on, if you guys can see that, yeah, this left side of my, this entire left side of my vest, you can tell, is completely dedicated to spare magazines. And I have 3 spare vector mags, so plus the one that I'm gonna start out with my gun, 95 rounds, this is called 100. Basically I have 400 rounds before I have to reload. So yeah, going downwards, right side, I have a double grenade pouch. So there are my 2 grenades that I'm going to have obviously full of green gas and BBs. On my left side here, we have, I'll undo it. This is a BB sock. So like a paintball, like in a paintball game when you'd have like, you know, those paintball tubes or whatever the hell they're called. This thing is a silent way to carry spare BBs if you're in the field and the game goes long for some reason. This is honestly more meant for mill sims, but when I was getting my kit, I figured I might as well get this just in case I need it. So this is like super cheap, like $8, $9. Go ahead and fill it now. Ooh. So, not that I can exactly remember, but I think this sock is meant to hold around 2,000 to 3,000 rounds of BBs. Because that was 5,600 rounds, and that was about half. I'm gonna bring all these BBs anyway, I'm gonna keep them in my car, so, you know. And it clips right to my butt. Right on my left butt cheek there. So, tactical belt, right side. Okay, this is a utility pouch for just like random stuff. Fortunately, the people that make all of this stuff, they really make it for male bodies, unfortunately. It's very hard for me to find any like female size options, and a lot of them they just claim to be universal size, one size fits all. Well, I'm 5'9 and like 120 some, and this is the smallest setting it can go to, and it doesn't fit my thigh at all. It still slides up and down. So the way I'm gonna plan on fixing that is I'm going to take these spare meshy corners here, and I'm going to fold them over on themselves about like an inch or so, punch a hole here, 2 zip ties, plastic zip ties, basically permanent. Do the same thing to this side, and I can take off about an inch that way. And that'll be enough to get this tight on my leg now. So. There we go. There's one. That's sort of the thing. I don't know if I'm gonna wear it because I left these. I like these holes so I can still touch triggers and stuff, and kind of takes away my. I need like a wetsuit, just like rubberized. Yep. So there's one zip tie through it. Now to zip tie this one side. There There we go. Four zip ties. Obviously, you can use scissors too if you want, but I'm an engineer and fuck scissors. Fuck scissors. It's either a knife or side cutters for me. Oh, it's closer. It's definitely closer. Not buckle for the pouch. The pouch has its buckle and lower into the upper. Yeah, doing the frags is always difficult. It's honestly easier to just take this off and go. Fucking frag pouch. Doing the frag pouch with this on is just, especially with this, it's just not gonna happen. It's just not gonna fucking happen. I'm being realistic. Just undoing it with one hand right now. There we go. Okay, vest is off. Nice and tight.
That's what she said.
Everything's almost packed. I thought about wearing my vest there, just wearing it, but that's probably not the wisest idea to wear what looks like a military vest in your car, but yeah. Which brings me to the last thing. You know, I had that American flag patch on me, and, you know, I'm not trying to, I mean, I am happy I live in America. God, my makeup is horrible. I am happy I live in America because, you know, the United States of America, chill people. Because here, we allow for HRT treatment. But only in some of the states. There are still states in my country that are largely ruled by religious sectors that think trans people are devil work. And they put them through aversion therapy. For people that don't know what aversion therapy is, they essentially drug you or do things like as intense as electroshock therapy to try to pray the gay away or pray the transness away. So I'm not really in support of all the things my country does. I think if anyone watched the occulted things, they know that. That's why instead of an American flag, I'll be rocking the LGBTQ rainbow flag and a dragon. Because these two symbols to me are myself and equality of all things. Even if we can only see so much of it. So yeah, that'll be on my plate. There we go. Now my plate carrier, my vest is ready to go. I'll see you.